White ESG now, I kind of ran through a little bit of this, but I mean, all of this, like that wall of money that I described, there's going to be, it's estimated, there's going to be 53 with a T trillion dollars dedicated or have a component of ESG in it by 2025.
Issue. My way of approaching it is this. It doesn't matter what you think. It's what others think that matters in the sense of the change that is coming because of those beliefs.
And you don't want to miss this party. To some extent, we've already had a massive rally in a lot of these like ETFs that are in this space. Now they've come off, some of them have come up already 20%, but that's because they went up so much. But this is not going away. This is going to continue to go.
I love that picture on the left side of your screen. This is actually a product from a South Korean company that was made. It's hilarious. This is one of the best examples of greenwashing, right? It says exactly what it says there. Hello, I'm a paper bottle. It is not a paper bottle. It is a plastic bottle that they wrapped in paper. That's probably one of the best examples of what we call greenwashing, where you're saying you're actually doing something, you know, for the environment, and you're really not.
Probably the biggest signature thing on this is COP26. And that's the big meeting that's going to occur in the UK, where over 100 countries are getting together to discuss the climate.
On the left side shows what we're going to get out of this conference. The nationally determined contributions, meaning the pledges that countries are doing to reduce the amount of CO2 in the air and methane as well, so that you can keep global temperatures from rising 1.5 Celsius. And
that's why you saw Joe Biden this week talk about climate. It's why China's Xi Jinping talked about it at the UN as well. We're going to see a lot more on this moving forward.
Look at what the surveys are saying on what they believe is important. 76% of older millennials think climate change is a serious threat to society. Well,
where are growth opportunities occurring? This COPLEX is investing in women-owned businesses. That's your social, that's your diversity aspect of investing. The survey results here on the right side are from Schwab, and they interviewed and surveyed their top RIA firms. And this is where they saw growth in their 2020 sales. What do you see at the end? 17% came from a more diverse crowd. So 17 to 20% for RRAs, that's a huge cohort. That's a huge sales opportunity for them. And that's, I make the business case for this, that, you know, if that's where you want to go, or if you see that as an opportunity, then what does your team look like?
Just to wrap this up, looking at some of these opportunities, and rethink the momentum that's building on this, we're going to reach a fever pitch very soon. The reinforcing steps that are being taken by government policy tells you that the momentum in this space is going to continue moving forward. And obviously, the supercharged trends that we've discussed and the hyper-focus by millennials on putting money to work for in this space, it really should be encouraging everyone to take a look at this.